Hi friends, welcome to my channel Code Canvas. In previous video, we learned about one of the best and useful ID selector in CSS. In this video, we will see a language pseudo class selector in CSS. So, the language pseudo class selector in CSS matches element based on the context of their given language attribute. Language in HTML is determined by combination of the attribute called lang is equal to language value, meta tag element, and by the information from the protocol such as HTTP accept language request header field. So let's see its syntax. Syntax will be lang, and in its value you can pass some language code like EN or FR for French, etc., etc. And you can apply whatever CSS you want to give. So, language and its value X matches if the element is in language X, whether the match is based on the identifier X being either equal to or hyphen separated substring of the element's language value in the same way as it performed by, like, let me show you a pipe separator, pipe one equal to. The matching of X against the element's language value is performed case insensitively for characters within the ASCII range. The identifier X does not have to be a valid language name. It's important to be noted that LANG language selector can be used globally or specifically on the given element. So, let's see an example how you can use. Let's say we have an HTML, as you can see in this HTML file. LANG language is equal to English, okay, and in view I'm adding one paragraph. In paragraph one, Q means short quotation tag is there, okay, and in for some content I'm just copying data from here, okay. So if I want to select, or if I want to apply some quotation marks before this paragraph tag, in CSS I can write down Q, which is tag, before I can add content, and in content you can give open quote, let's see, and in Q after, same as before, you can also give after, and here you can give close quote. Okay, so let's see how it applies. As you can see, the open quotes and close quotes are there, and right now the language is English. So we can still apply lang of en, the value of this HTML tag en space Q. It will select the Q tag, and here you can give the values of quotes. Let's say we can give double quote space again double quote. So this is the default quotes, open and close one. Let's say we have another language, the French one, okay, and FR is a language code for French. So as you can see, in this is the default quotation mark, but if you want to override, you can give lang, here you can give FRQ, and you can give quotes, and you can easily write down like this. It should be single quote. It is recommended. Okay, let's see. As you can see, we can apply the P, Q and before. Before, open quote is applied based on this FR, French language selection. Let's say we have a German language. For that, it will be BE, the language code. And to select, we can write down LANG, BE, Q, quotes, and single quotes. You can simply use the opposite arrows, right, for German language. So it will be displayed like this. Let me remove this to CSS, and as you can see, this is the default open quote and close quote for German language. Here you have to make a note that you cannot use this CSS pseudo selector for some elements, for few elements. The example is applet is the one element, another is base. You cannot use base with this language attribute. Base font is the other one. The next is the break line VR tag, that you cannot use this language. Next one is frame, right? You cannot use frame for this language parameter. Same as frame, you cannot use iframe as well. The next one is param, you cannot use param as well, and the script one. So you need to take care that while using one of these tags, you cannot use this language attribute, and you cannot select based on this LANG language CSS pseudo selector. And about browser support, today almost all the browsers are supported for this language, and it is very one of the useful CSS pseudo selector in CSS. So that's all for this video. I hope you like this video. Don't forget to subscribe. See you next time around. Thank you.